بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، والحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى الله على محمد وآله الطاهرين. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إذا ألقوا فيها سمعوا لها شهيقا وهي تفور. When they are thrown in it, they hear it blaring as it seethes. The Quran tries to describe to us the hellfire. It's very difficult for us to comprehend what that afterworld is going to look like. But some examples are given in the Quran relating them to our world to help us comprehend. On that day, we will see our deeds and our actions. As stated in Surah Al-Zalzala, فَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ خَيْرًا يَرَهُ وَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ شَرًّا يَرَهُ. Anyone who does an atom weight like of a deed, good deed, he will see it. And anyone who does an atom weight like of a bad deed, he will see it. So we will see our actions. Who enters into the hellfire? وَالْعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ. In Surah Al-Muddathir, which is Surah number 74, verses 43 to 47, give us four descriptions and characteristics of those who enter into the hellfire. The people in paradise will ask the people in the hellfire, what got you to the hellfire? And they will respond as follows. First, in verse number 43, قَالُوا لَمْ نَكُ مِنَ الْمُصَلِّينَ. They will answer, we were not among those who prayed. Establishing salat is extremely important, brothers and sisters. It keeps the harm away from us, inshallah, and hellfire away from us, in addition to bringing us rizq and sustenance as well. Second, وَلَمْ نَكُ نُطْعِمُ الْمِسْكِينَ. Nor did we feed the poor. Salat is your connection to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's the perfection of the soul, of the ruh, of the self, of the nafs, of the heart, of the qalb. That then stems onto your organs and limbs and actions. Reaching out to the community, reaching out to the society. These individuals did not have any connection to their Lord, submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nor did they care about the surroundings, the society, their environment, their community. وَلَمْ نَكُ نُطْعِمُ الْمِسْكِينَ. Third, وَكُنَّا نَخُوضُ مَعَ الْخَائِضِينَ. We used to gossip along with the gossipers. Here, the gossipers, not necessarily people who are backbiting. Anyone who's promoting things of Allah's disobedience could be an ideology. People who promote ideologies that deviate people, وَالْعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ. People who promote actions, deeds, harmful music, the haram kind of music that deviates people, and so on and so forth. So any kind of, وَالْعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ, deviation, that's the kind of deviation that they used to promote and sit with people who promoted, وَالْعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ. And fourth, وَكُنَّا نُكَذِّبُ بِيَوْمِ الدِّينِ. And we used to deny the day of retribution or the day of judgment. Those people who defy Allah, وَالْعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ, the mushrikeen, the kafirin, such individuals end up into the hellfire, وَالْعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ, until they said, death came to us. When death came, reality strikes. Imam Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salam says, people are asleep, when they die, they wake up. In addition, the hellfire, as we see from this verse, shahiq, it also has zafir. In Surah Al-Furqan, verse 12, Allah says, إِذَا رَأَتْهُم مِّن مَكَانٍ بَعِيدٍ سَمِعُوا لَهَا تَغَيُّضًا وَزَفِيرًا. When it sees them, Jahannam, sees them from a distance. Some ahadith say 500 years. In the Akhirah, time is measured in years. Distance is measured in years. Just like when we have, for example, in this world, for faraway objects that are measured in light years. They're not measured in distance anymore. In the Akhirah also, things are measured in year. It is said that Jahannam, people would feel it from 500 years away. وَالْعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ, وَالْعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ. The good thing is Jannah is also 500 years away. You can smell it and get to it. So imagine how far people are away from the paradise and how near they are to Jahannam, that from 500 years they can smell it. They can feel it. It can see them. And when they see it, or when it sees them, they hear it inhaling and exhaling, but that inhale and exhale is such fearful sounds, والعياذ بالله, that would really overwhelm people. May Allah keep us away from that fear. Jahannam has 7 gates. Or Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salam says these gates are one on top of the other. It's like, you know, basically going from one level down to another level, down to another level. He says the most bottom level, the Hawiya, Sa'ir, Jahim, Saqar, Hutama, Lava, and Jahannam. These are the 7 levels. Each level, wal'iyadu billah, has a gate. It is narrated that Prophet Zakariya alayhi salam one day was talking about the hellfire. So his son, Prophet Yahya alayhi salam, came and started listening. Prophet Zakariya said that in Jahannam there is a mountain called As-Sakran. In the essence of that mountain is a valley. It's called Al-Ghadban. It's angry for the anger and the wrath of the Lord, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Inside that valley is a hole. The distance of that hole is 100 years. As I mentioned, distance is measured in years. 100 years deep in a hole. So it's a valley. In a valley, it's a deep hole, 100 years. In that hole, there are coffins of fire. Inside these coffins of fire are boxes of fire, clothes of fire, chains of fire. وَالْعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ When Yahya heard of this, he started crying, weeping until he fainted, and he said, what will save me from the Sakaran? This is a prophet of God, Prophet Yahya alayhi salam. He's weeping, he's crying. So my brothers and sisters, we really have to be careful of the Akhirah, of this hellfire. The food, according to the Quran, of the people of the hellfire is dhari' wal'iyadu billah, zakum, ghislin, things that are painful to eat, painful to drink, things that would boil the stomach, boil the inside of the human being, wal'iyadu billah. My brothers, my sisters, let us do istighfar and ask Allah to keep the harm of the hellfire away from us. It is narrated when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi ascended to the Mi'raj, he passed by the fire. And he saw people burning, he saw people being punished. Among the punishments he saw was people who were eating rotten flesh. وَالْعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ Terrible smell, terrible looks, terrible food, but they were eating it. He said, Ya Jibra'il, why are these people eating this raw, rotten flesh? He said, these were the people who used to backbite. The Quran says, does one of you like to eat the dead flesh of his brother? You hate it. That would be the punishment also on the Day of Judgment. He saw people being punished for listening to haram music. He saw people being punished for not wearing the hijab. He saw people being punished for stealing, for taking money away, for oppressing others, wal'iyadu billah, such that it is said when he came down to earth, he was never seen smiling again. Wal'iyadu billah. May Allah keep the harm of Jahannam away from us. Bi barakat as-salati ala Muhammadin wa ali Muhammad. Because the salawat and the istighfar and the tears crying for Ahlul Bayt, it really extinguishes the fire of the hellfire, keeps it away from the person, meaning that the person would not be burned by these fires. May Allah keep us on the Sirat al-Mustaqim, Sirat Muhammadin wa Ali Muhammad, wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.